guy, completely wrote these separately. I had no idea that his was going to sound a lot like mine. But I do think that it shows Tom's consistency.
It does, it does.
And I apologize that I have to read everything, but I'm like super nervous, so I'm going to get through this. I first want to thank the Sarasolis, Lees, and Chens for making tonight come together so well. Thank you to Tom for allowing me to speak. Thank you to Teresa for accepting Tom as he is.
Don't be nervous.
Over here, if it's easier. I also want to thank Teresa for encouraging me to be as vulgar as possible in this thing. Giving me no rules.
Yes.
For those that don't know me, I'm a family friend of Tom. I say a family friend because I was born into this friendship. Much like brothers, when they're born, they're immediately brothers. So maybe I should say, I'm not just a friend of Tom, I'm another brother.
Yeah. Agreed.
He's a brother whose jokes I've been forced to laugh at because we all know Tom's sense of humor is like nobody else's, except for Mike, his twin brother. And to be fair, I do support the theory that if you throw enough feces at the wall, some of it will stay. So to Tom, please feel free, keep throwing your jokes at me, I'll continue to act as your wall. I want to share a couple stories from our childhood. I need to preface this by admitting these are stories that my parents are hearing for the first time tonight, so it might get a little awkward for me, and if you guys want, you can go to the bathroom. When I was little, I used to like to steal my brother's fireworks and light them at the dead end of my house. So I stole a bunch of fireworks, I brought Tom, I think Mike was there too, but I certainly brought Tom down there, and I lit a firework, and it went off in my hand, and I ran in my flip-flops back to my house, which is about 3 or 4 yards away, and I was fast. I got to my house. I needed to make sure that my fingers were still there. Tom comes behind me because I beat him in everything. So he's like, dude, you just ran faster than anybody I know in flip-flops. How'd you do that? I'm like, man, you don't care if my fingers are there? Sports prowess before my fingers? Another very fun story. Not even sure that I should. Well, all right, so I also used to like, I would go into the woods and like things on fire. Like, 12-year-old kid. I'm not a pyromaniac, I lit things on fire. And so I had a sweet fire going. Again, Tom was there. I had the sweet fire in the woods going with no proper, you know, fire extinguisher, nothing. But it was a huge stump, and this thing was going. So I was paying attention. I was good. I finally put it out, and I turn around and look at Tom. Tom's not there. I was like, man, where's Tom? So I go home. I call Tom, and he answers his house phone. And I said, Tom, where did you go? And I hear Mrs. Sarasoli in the background go, just tell him you don't like lighting things on fire. I said, man, you're a rat. You just ratted me out. That's awful. That's messed up. And I know everyone's looking at me right now thinking, wow, what a jerk Tom is. And the reason I share these stories is because, in true Sarasoli fashion, he was just worried about my safety and wanted to make sure that I was okay and always safe. And that's what Sarasolis do, including Tom. And I think this illustrates Tom's really thick candy shell that we have all gotten through and now know the sweet, caring inner Tom and that we all love. The problem I had 2 years ago is I would think to myself, the amount that Tom loves to argue, plus his thick candy shell, he's never gonna find a girlfriend. What type of girl can take the arguing that comes with Tom? So I see him one day, he says, "Hey, I went on a couple dates with this awesome girl." I thought to myself, what kind of mental institution did she come from? But I said, "Oh yeah, tell me about it." He starts by saying, "She's a lawyer." I'm not too sure what he said after that, because I'm thinking to myself, this guy's a genius. Of course a lawyer can take his arguing, but what about his jokes? She can't take them, can she? Well, I got to meet her for the first time. She begins trashing every single one of Tom's awful jokes. She did it publicly and brutally. So brutal, I fell in love with her. Not like a man-woman, but like a teammate. A teammate that will be able to trash Tom with me. Over the next couple of years, I got to spend time with Tom Risa, and every time, I loved him more and more. Teresa brings out the best in Tom I've ever seen. I think we all see a much different Tom, and it's the best Tom that we had always known had been hiding under that thick candy shell.
Yeah.
Teresa, I don't know how you do it. Frankly, nobody does. But we all thank you for sticking it out. I imagine it was a tough mountain to climb, but I must admit, the real winner here is me. Because I get to add an awesome new sister to my family tonight. Thank you. I love you both.